searching all night for
her,
the beautiful one I danced the evening with.
Where did she go?
She disappeared like the fine morning mist.
She was lovely.
The lovely.
I'm not certain of that. I must confess, I too have a lovely maiden. She lives here, in the woods.
In the woods?
Yes, in the top of a tall tower, with no doors or stairs.
Where?
2 leagues from here, due east, just beyond the mosque.
And how do you manage a visit?
I stand beneath your tower and say, Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair to me. And she lowers the most beautiful head of hair, yellow as corn, which I climbed.
Rapunzel! What kind of name is that? You jest? I have never heard of such a thing.
I speak the truth. She's as true as your maiden. A maiden running from a prince. None would run from us.
Yes, one has. Did I abuse her or show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, how shall I regain the heart she has won from me? Agony beyond power of speech. When the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach.
High in a tower, she sits by the hour, retaining her hair. Live and becoming, and frequently humming, a light-hearted air.
Agony, far more painful than yours. When you know she would go with you, if there only were doors. Agony, oh, the torture they teach. What's as intriguing or half so fatiguing as what's out of reach? Am I not sensitive, clever, well-mannered, considerate, passionate, charming, as kind as I'm handsome, and heir to a throne?
You are everything maids could wish for,
and why not
do I know?
The girl must be mad!
You know nothing of madness till you're climbing her hair, and you sweep her up there as you're nearing her, all the while hearing her,
I must have her to run.